Going on to the next game, we got Wagner. The Wagner Seahawks traveling to the Buffalo Bulls. And while I was just talking about Ball State earlier, this is the other flip side of the coin, where if Ball State doesn't win the MAC, it's most definitely going to be Buffalo. Buffalo Bulls have been dominating the MAC ever since I started watching football. They have been the dominant team in the MAC. And I think that last year was the first year that I was watched that since I've been watching football that Buffalo didn't win the MAC. And that was a huge thing last year, at least for me. But it's like if you've been watching Clemson since it would be like if Clemson lost the ACC. Except for it's like a little bit less than that, obviously, because it's Group of Five. But it's still a huge shock to me that Buffalo lost the MAC. And now they're going against Wagner week one, the Wagner Seahawks, right? I mean, pronounce Wagner. If I'm butchering the name, that's my apologies. They went 0-2 last year. They did not do well at all. Again, they only played two games. So, I mean, I don't think that's a fair comparison to Buffalo, who played seven games. They had Jarrett Patterson, who's one of the best running backs. He was one of the best running backs in the draft last year. Although he went undrafted, he's making a big deal with the Redskins in the NFL. But Buffalo was really solid last year, really solid team. And they beat Marshall, I believe, in the bowl game without Jarrett Patterson. So that proves they can beat top-tier teams without Jarrett Patterson. Plus, they have they had a whole offseason to regroup. Buffalo's favored by 43.5 points in this game, and I honestly do think they will cover this. Wagner is not a very good FCS team. Now, Buffalo did lose the MAC last year, but again, it's against Ball State. That's going to be the real game, but Buffalo should easily win this one on ESPN3.